Hi, my name is Rishi Hazra, and I'm a sophomore at Skyline High School of the Issaquah School District. Today, we'll be taking a look at SnowTel. Now, the term SnowTel stands for snow telemetry, or in other words, it means the transfer of data regarding snow. And the data collected by SnowTel stations relate generally to the climate. The ones depicted here as blue dots measure data regarding snowpack and rainfall. And these specific SnowTel stations are mainly located around mountainous regions. As you can see, they cross the Cascades here and the Olympic Mountain Range on the left. The data these SnowTel stations gather can be used by water managers to plan water usage and conserve this vital natural resource. And this is an image of the SnowTel Report Generator 2.0, created by the Natural Resources Conservation Service of the U.S. Department of Agriculture. And we can use this report generator to create data reports and analyze the data from the SnowTel sites across the country. I've used this generator to create two reports, both of which use data collected at Skookum Creek. And Skookum Creek is located in the Tolt watershed. And that's the watershed that supplies the drinking water for my community. The first report I generated was for the 2015 water year, as we can see here in the x-axis, ranging from October 1st of 2014 to October 1st of 2015. And I took the snow water equivalent as my data of interest, which is plotted here on the y-axis. I compared the snow water equivalent in 2015 to the average computed by comparing the data from 1981 to 2010, and which is shown here in red. Now, immediately, we can see that there's this huge difference in snow water equivalents from the average to 2015. The average peaked at about 30 inches in April, whereas the 2015 values peaked at about 5 inches in January. And that indicates that 2015 was a drought year. We can also see that after April 1st, it seems that the SnowTel site in 2015 stopped collecting data. And that highlights an important point, which is that SnowTel stations aren't perfect. They require regular maintenance by specially trained SnowTel teams, who either hike up or are dropped off by helicopter at these SnowTel stations. Now for 2015, it seems likely that this drought may have caused some of the SnowTel sensors to malfunction. But beyond this potential malfunctioning of SnowTel sensors, the 2015 drought had some significant impacts. Northwest wheat farmers struggled to plant and crop harvest rates fell. Forest fire smoke smothered the August sky. People with asthma struggled. Soccer practices were canceled for weeks. The elderly died. The drought of 2015 had some severe, long-lasting impacts. But droughts are not the only irregularity in precipitation and snow water equivalents that can have these kind of impacts. Flood years can leave lasting damage as well. Let's shift our focus to this graph here, which shows the water year of 2009 and the snow water equivalent compared to the average. We can see here that the snow water equivalent of 2009 peaked at about 60 inches, whereas the average peaked at only about half of that, at 30 inches. And that's what made 2009 a flood year and brought about some severe impacts across our region. Local floods shut down traffic, roads were flooded, cars were swept away. There was chaos in our infrastructure. Floods eroded the soil of our local farms, ruining our crops and harming the northwestern farming economy. The floods destroyed salmon habitat, displacing hundreds of thousands of salmon across our region. Both the 2009 flood and the 2015 drought left lasting impacts in our society. We can only look back and analyze these anomalies because of the reports we can generate from the data collected by these SnowTel stations. If you would like to generate your own data reports to analyze the snowpack in certain years like 2009 or 2015, the link to Report Generator 2.0 and a tutorial on how to use it will be made available in the description below. Thank you!